There's a wonderful feeling of achievement when that first flashlight goes off. And you love it and you think it's great. And then you need it. And then you've got to have it. And then you've got to stay in the limelight. It becomes a totally addictive thing, and you've got to have more.
Perfect.
Okay. I am an actress.
Oh, my Lord. For Jade, or it all came crashing down. She fucked up.
This is not 1945. We're not fighting each other anymore. These are our partners, they're our colleagues, and our future lies in Europe.
Talking and texting made them Britain's favorite gadget. Now phones with pictures.
When we first launched, we were hoping for, you know, maybe 400, 500 people. And now we're at 100,000 people, so who knows where we're going next.
No sooner has one reality television show shrunk into a blip on our television screens than another flares into life.
Society now has been hijacked. Everybody wants to be a celebrity now, and that is the standard by which you're judged.
Back in the 2000s, I used to run a nightclub called the Embassy Club in Mayfair. It was, you know, the big shit. Right, if you couldn't get in, you were nobody. It was the ultimate club for tits and footballers, right? Daniel Lloyd, Kerry Katona, Jordan. We had every Page 3 model, we had every Premiership footballer, John Terry, Frank Lampard, everybody. There was William and Kay with her in her fishnets getting into a taxi. Essex royalty and real royalty. And then, of course, Jade come in. Listen, this is a kid that came from a broken home, drug dealer father, drug, you know, and all that sort of stuff in Bermondsey from a little council flat. And she became one of the most famous women in the UK. She loved the limelight. She loved being important. She was a proper princess in her own castle. And then London nightlife got sort of taken over by this mad paparazzi demand for these reality stars. I remember one time there were 30 or 40 paparazzi outside, and I remember watching Paul McCartney walk down the road past them. And because I knew a few of them, I went, boys, there's Paul McCartney. And I went, nah, not interested in his picture. They wanted Jade.
Oh, God, Jade's always wanted to be something. Always been wanting to be a star since she was a baby. When she came out of Big Brother house, she just got bigger and bigger and bigger.
Singing Rose Garden live, Jade Goody is...
It was amazing because she even went into Stars in Your Eyes. When she went on stage, she said this old lady looked at her with the dirtiest look ever, and she heard her say, who does she think she is? She can't sing.
I beg your pardon.
It was great for Jade to prove that she weren't as thick and stupid and as silly as you really all thought. She did have a talent somewhere in her life.
And the winner is... Lynn Anderson!
Listen, Jade was at the top of her game. She believed she had made it and she was on her way to something special. She'd gone from Bermondsey to Essex, and the next step for her was Hollywood. She'd often said to me that Jason Statham's done it. I'm going to go next.
Jade Goody was a hit. You know, she wasn't anything else but a hit. But she did deal in the rougher end of the business. And if you don't get things right, there's a good chance you'll get a kick in the teeth.
Here we go, guys. Major applause when you hear the title sequence. Here we go. Enjoy tonight's Celebrity Big Brother. Here we go.
Tonight, Jade's back. But this time, she's bought the family.
The producers wanted to make the show bigger. You know, and they wanted Jade. She was the queen of Big Brother. So we sat down to talk about her. They offered 50 grand. Not bad.
I was at the peak of my career, but my agent thought it was a good opportunity and can't really go that bad for me. They told me the worst that could happen is that I don't win it. The best that could happen is that I win here.
I think it sort of appealed to her because the show had completely changed her life. So I think she felt she owed the show a debt of gratitude as much as anything else.
And so she said yes. Her parting shot was that it made me, I hope it's not going to break me.
It's time now to check out the house. It is not easy in there. The producer's chat to potential housemates was, don't do it. Don't go into Big Brother.
Brace yourselves, I'm going in.
It's gonna ruin your life. Okay. It's gonna ruin all of your friends' lives. It's okay. Definitely gonna ruin your family's life. But people wanted to be in there so much that they were just like that. Yeah, we got you, we hear you. Yeah, fine, yeah, ruin my life, yeah, great, yeah, I'll do it, yeah. Where do I sign?
What are you doing now, Jade?
Well, I've got quite a lot to do. I've got to vote. And I have to also go to my new ass, and have a meeting. I've got quite a bit to do, but I think it's very important that I make my vote today. Because, like everyone keeps saying, your vote counts. So I get a vote for the first time ever.
Good evening. A majority of British people believe that multiculturalism is making Britain a better place.
We know migration has been good for Britain. We are a nation comfortable with the open world of today.
Jade was the new Queen of Essex. She'd finished with Jeff, she'd got these amazing kids, she'd have a great life. And she had nobody to share it with. And up pops this fella.
I knew she was very loud and outgoing, and I'm a typical Essex boy. I was in a club called 195 in Epping, and a mate come up to me and said, my mate really likes you, can she have your number? I said, all right, yeah, go on, why not?
He was Essex through and through. Good looking, pretty boy, wore all the right clothes.
He was a football agent, he was 22, you know, and she was just like, oh my God.
I think they're all football agents, though, in Loughton.
And then I think it was like front page of the newspaper, he was like 18 and didn't have a job. We all found it quite amusing.
I'm going to tell her I was a 17-year-old apprentice electrician. I wouldn't get anywhere, so I had to make up a little white lie somewhere.
She had the house, the car, now she had the boy.
Do you love me, Jack?
It's too early to anything like that. We're just having fun at the moment. You love me, Jade?
Just biding my time, seeing what else comes along.
It fitted the image, having the good-looking boy and everything else, and they became a celebrity couple. She moulded him into what she wanted him to be.
I wasn't really into that sort of lifestyle. I think it was after like a month and a half, she said, OK magazine, want to do a photo shoot with us? I said, no, I'm not doing that. That's embarrassing. That was
And all the boys would rip me at work. I'm like, I can't do that. She said, yeah, they're going to pay us like 15, 20 grand each. It's like, yeah, Dad, I can't come in tomorrow. I'll quit.
I got a really lovely surprise one day. Jade said we're going on a holiday. I said, who with? She said, me, you and Jack.
We had to get helicopter to take us away. So it was all a bit mad, so we didn't really have a chance to even think about what was going to happen.
And then the next thing, the cars are driving us up to where all the studios are. I said, Jade, what are we doing here? What the fuck are we doing here? Oh, I said, please, Jade, you know I didn't want to go into Big Brother. Mum, you need the money. Oh, we had to go through doctors to psychiatrists. You have to go through a lot of people, you know, to find out mentally that you're fit enough to go in there. I was petrified.
Jade was going into that house as the nation's sweetheart. We were excited about that. And I couldn't wait to see what she brought. And I couldn't wait to see how she mixed with a Jackson.
The lineup of that house was so mad, really, when you think about it. You had Jermaine Jackson, who's the gentlest, loveliest man.
Michael's in Vegas right now, but he has a way of seeing everything.
I mean, Ken Russell. I mean, he was a kind of filmmaking hero of mine.
It was an amazing mix of people. And like Shilpa Shetty, Bollywood superstar. Billions of people watch her.
Hey.
Hey.
Hello. Hiya, hello.
Hello.
Hello, Jade.
Are you our new guest?
Jack.
Hello. I'm an actress from India.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. And I'm an old age pension.
He's a very famous filmmaker. And that's Jermaine Jackson.
Oh my god.
This is different.
So as well as Jade and her mum, we had Danielle Lloyd. I think she was a kind of model wag at that point.
And then there's Neil Sear. We had a really strong mix. All the celebrities. Johnny Tourette.
What do you do, darling?
I was in Big Brother.
Oh, you were?
4.5 years ago.
You must be mad.
And you came back for more?
Yeah.
If you've been in that house once and you go back in, you're not going back in for fun. Jade knew. She'd been in. She knew how hard it was, but it was a business deal, right? For her, it was like, we go in that house. We're reality TV stars for another few years.
I want to tell you all my secrets. So I've written a biography. Oh, sorry, an autobiography. She wasn't stupid. She knew that she had to keep doing stuff for people to be talking about her, and they wanted to know the story of her upbringing.
When she had said, oh, Mum, I'm going to do my autobiography, I was petrified. I remember saying to her, no, 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 no. She went, Mum, why not? I am not going to put anything in my book to hurt you.
The little girl that we see on the back there, what was her life like?
It was nothing like this. It was, you know, I don't want people to feel sorry for me or anything like that, because there are people out there that have had a harder life than me, but it wasn't easy.
After Jade's autobiography, some big things come out, you know, this one-armed lesbian crackhead. So my whole life completely changed. I could be sitting indoors and there'd be knocks on the door, you know, from journalists asking me for interviews. And they'd offer me this money, that money. She started trying to make me into a celebrity.
On Extreme Makeover, Jade's mum, 48-year-old grandmother Jackie Budden.
Around that time, there was pressures on producers to kind of push the boundaries, push the limits. Shows like Extreme Makeover that Jackie was in started, well, being more extreme.
to turn back the clock, she'll be having a full face and brow lift, laser eye surgery to correct her vision, her nose reshaped, full dental restoration to improve her smile, and her breasts enlarged.
Oh, God, I was like a lollipop wrapped up in a bandage.
Well, I'm going to look very sweet when I'm all I'm done.
Mum, you want to come on down?
Jade's called me Cinderella, and that's what she done it for, to make me a princess, and wow, did I feel like a princess.
Jade was on this celebrity journey, and now her mum was a proper celebrity too.
Hey, do you want to meet Jade's mum? I almost didn't recognise you. You look so completely different.
I know. I'm fabulous now, ain't I?
I did say earlier, I said there's one thing that can't change your voice.
No, sorry about that.
Oh, my God!
This is not good. What's the door? Do I just push it? Oh, my gosh. Hi, everyone.
Hello.
This is my mum, Jackie.
Hi. Everyone was lovely. Everyone was fine. Until I got introduced to this lady.
Oh, you were
Shilpa. Shilpa.
Shilpa.
Shilpa.
Shilpa.
Shilpa.
S-H-I-L-P-A.
It's Shilpa.
Please.
It's Shilpa. You'll have to call. Shilpa.
Yeah.
Shilpa. Do you mind?
We've had this idea that because Big Brother had created these working class celebrities, we thought that we would turn that on its head and put celebrities in with people that had been on Big Brother.
Oh, I like this.
And that was part of the reason that we created the Masters and Servants task.
Now, Jermaine, Ken and Shilpa are about to become honorary members of Jade's family. Now, Jade's family will be treated like royalty by their celebrity servants who live next door. Sounds great, doesn't it?
Jade Goody is a girl who was in the Big Brother house a couple of years ago.
This is her life.
Yeah.
I wouldn't base my career on this.
I suppose we mustn't be too friendly with the servants.
I don't know. Shilpa and Jermaine are the pros of that. They've got servants.
How many have you got?
Three servants and three chauffeurs. My makeup artist, hairdresser. I have a man Friday who travels with me everywhere that I go.
Oh, you mean a bodyguard person?
No, that's separate.
Oh, separate.
It's not something I'd recommend for anyone to go and do. I couldn't really even speak to these people properly. Like, that was just, they lived in a different world than me.
Well, I'd rather have gone into the servants' house.
I know, that's what I was gonna say. This is too posh for me.
Posh?
No, like them three. They're not all posh and good.
It's all about, you could say conflict, but you could, I think what you want to do is create some tension. Like any good story has some tension in it.
Oh my good God.
That's, you know, part of what makes Big Brother fun.
I've got my back to you.
Oh my God.
Hello.
Hello.
Now, we're reporting. Ready for duty.
I think I was asked to go in there because Jade was going in. I'd written so much bad stuff about her. I said she had the character of a slug. She had tumbleweed for brains. So here was the great irony, that I was going to be a servant to Jade Goody.
The housekeeper must thoroughly clean the bathroom, lounge, kitchen, living area, using the equipment provided.
The housekeeper, the people that they made the servants were some of the people who thought themselves to be the biggest stars in the house. And there were we, at the beck and call of what many would call the Chav family. And so the Jade effect, I mean, took hold almost immediately.
Eight. Give us an hand there, let's have a look. Stand up.
Donny Toretto, well, I kind of knew he'd never stay.
Say goodbye.
Are you going?
For us. Yeah.
Fuck off, are you serious?
Mate, I'm out of here, man.
Are you serious?
I'm not fucking waiting hand and foot on some fucking moron than their family.
Are you serious?
Yeah, mate, I'm out.
I can't see where he's going.
Good
luck,
mate. Oh,
mate,
take care.
They're dirty. Mine's very dirty. They hated it. I was white trash. Started calling me white trash behind our backs.
You can sit there, and all of the celebrities were our slaves. They had to do what everything Goody's family wanted. Polish her shoes, give her dinner.
That smells delicious.
I need my gravy a bit hotter, please. Listen, you're joking. We had them running around like rings.
Thank you. Leo Sayer minded. He really minded.
That's absolutely fabulous.
Not only did he not think they were celebrities, he just thought they were hideous people.
Well, Jade Goody is going to win this thing anyway. Because that's the kind of people they want.
That. Bunch of fucking
I'm out of here.
No!
Fuck this, I'm out of here. This is bullshit.
No, no, wait.
Fuck off.
Show it together.
Fuck off. Get out of my way. Fuck off. You don't. You've got nothing to do with me. Fuck off. Fuck off.
Calm down. Gallery, we've got him here.
Leo walked out and refused to speak to anyone on the team and said he was only going to speak to the police.
Fuck you. Fuck you.
And at the time, the bill was on. So all their, like, police cars that aren't real police cars were outside lined up. Subsequently got in what he thought was a police car, but was actually just a car from the bill. And then he sat there, and he's like, I'm not speaking to you, I'm going to talk to the police.
I think this is all a sick joke.
And then the exec said, Leah, that's not a real police car.
Uncle Ken, I don't think you're meant to do that.
Ken, because you've been impatient, you've blown the task, and it's not fair on all those people that are trying
dear,
to do their
don't
best.
Make me cry.
Ken Russell was in there and he was a massive fan of the show. So I was sort of quite surprised by his reaction to Jade.
Why are you not bothered?
I think you're slightly demented, darling. You should be put in a straitjacket.
Oh, if that's what you think, then that's fine. But you should have had the respect and consideration of these people.
Jade, tell Carol.
They're not people, darling. They're not people.
Yes, they are people. They're not
animals.
They're servants.
They're servants. They're servants.
Oh, my God.
Servants
are still human beings.
No, they're not. They're
servants are still human beings.
They're slaves. It's a different class of people, darling.
Here, obviously, A-listers like yourself. A-listers like yourself, you're right. It's a different class of people, and they're not. The A-listers like yourself. Yes, Ken, you're right. Do what you want.
I shall, darling. Don't worry.
Yeah, I bet you will.
And then Ken Russell left quite quickly after that as well. We had quite a few departures, quite a lot of exits.
Left my slippers under the chaise longue.
We have an Asian menu, a Japanese menu, and an Indian menu. Okay, you're allowed one starter, one main dish, and one side dish each.
Jackie was a very difficult person to be around. You could be talking to her and all of a sudden her mood would change and it would be aggressive.
Right, 1 minute, we'll bring one each time. One at a time.
You want me to
one at a time. No. No, I can do it. I was so wanted to do it.
Let her do it.
I wanted to do it.
Let her do it.
Jade tried very, very hard to control it, but she was just very unpredictable.
Please, I'm fine. Leave me, please. Chappelle, leave me. Or whatever your name is, please leave me. Ship. Say it, do you mean? Yes?
Ship her.
This is the first time anyone has ever spoken to me like that. I'm in shock.
People who are from a certain, you know, class, if you like, look at people from another class and they say they don't like them because maybe they're scared of it. Her whole life, nobody paid her any attention.
You know, that's what
she was nowhere.
About.
Her daughter becomes famous and ergo she becomes famous. And suddenly she's in this spotlight.
It was the baddest vibes ever you could get. I know that these people don't like me.
Oh, God. Hello, big brother.
Jackie, the public have been voting since Friday. And Big Brother can now reveal that the first housemate to be evicted is you.
No!
You will not be able to say your goodbyes.
No!
The door to your right will now open.
Oh, no! What about my eviction clothes? Do I go out like this?
Please leave the Big Brother house.
I've got no shoes on.
I think the way that she was evicted, when you look back at it, is quite difficult for Jade to deal with.
It's fucking nasty.
Jackie's eviction
had a massive effect on Jade.
She's not prepared.
Sorry, love.
It was a very clever way to set up a row for the future and to set up resentments and bitterness. And it did.
You didn't even give her 5 minutes. I wanted to come to a woman and say it'd be all right. You didn't let me do that. I will never forgive you for that. I just don't like what you've done. This is just a nasty game.
There's a massive argument brewing in the house between Shilpa and Jade, so let's take a little peek.
After Jackie's eviction, we started to notice some fractious relationship between the girls and Shilpa.
There was Jade and Joe and Danny, who didn't like Shilpa and were gossiping about her, slagging her off behind her back.
I'm just fed up of fucking having to eat when she wants to eat, and
yeah,
she has to cook everything. She's fucking doing my head in. She's fucking funny little.
I remember almost immediately thinking, this is a bad combo. It's like three British young girls all coming together and then forming a gang, basically.
Anybody for bleach?
What is that?
Bleach.
Fuck off.
Bleach?
She's bleaching your facial hair.
Yeah, she shaves her face.
Has she got a face like a man?
Like Wolf Boy, probably.
It started to be bullying. And I was like, man, you are careering off the tracks. You are so going in the wrong direction.
I can't believe she does her makeup in the toilet all discreet but walks out with that on her face.
Yeah, I know.
Saying I've got a big hairy face. My name is bleach.
There was, yeah, mimicking of accents. It's a kind of, yeah, low-level racism, I suppose you'd call it at that point.
Don't you feel it, Jermaine?
Huh?
Can't you feel the vibe?
Certainly, you know, talking about somebody based on their culture and their race, and it wasn't good. And we started to get complaints, so you could sort of feel it bubbling up.
Where is the chicken stock?
Guys, have you all used up the chicken stock cubes?
There's one left, yeah.
One left.
You all used four cubes?
Four or three?
Must have been four, yeah.
Three, I think.
Four?
Four.
Whatever, yeah.
Three or four. Just require one. It's the only thing I had ordered.
That's the only thing what?
That I had ordered.
It's not the fucking only thing you ordered, you liar. So what? I get an OXO cube. Shoot me in my pissing head. Fucking wanker.
You know what? I don't need to dignify this stupid, stupid argument. It may be fun
for
you, Jade.
Caused by you, because you said the only thing you ordered was OXO cubes, which is
an out and out lie. Shut up.
No, I won't shut up. You shut up.
Jade lost the plot quite frequently.
Who the fuck are you to tell me to shut up? You might be some princess in fucking Neverland, but I don't give a shit. You're not no fucking princess here. You're a normal housemate like everybody else.
Because I think she still had me in her head. She retaliated the way she did with Shilpa. I think that was a part of it.
This was the only thing I ordered off the shop.
I ordered the condiments. Oh, please, learn some manners.
You're so far up your ass, you can smell your own shit. You're fucking ridiculous.
You know what? Your claim to fame is this. Good for you.
My claim to fame is meeting you, you fucking loser.
It was absolutely, it was terrifying. I think back then there was still a naivety because we were doing what we normally do, trying to take an irreverent look at the house and the minutiae of people's behaviour, and then suddenly this happens. It went from some kind of Channel 4 exec in kind of, you know, combat trousers and the T-shirt going, hey guys, this is fantastic, to just an awful lot of serious looking suit wearing people going, we need to cover this in a responsible manner. And you're like, that's not us.
Fucking go to your community and go around to all those people that look up to you and be real, you fucking fake!
Oh. Paul Morley,
offer some insight on that.
I think the thing is, before these celebrities have got used to being in there, they've had the goodies to deal with. They've had the, not only Jade, but, you know, Jack.
Hold on. What point do you want to make?
I remember being invited on to sort of speak authoritatively on what was happening, as if we could calm it down a little bit. As if you could sort of suggest on their behalf that it's OK, we're in control, but the producers had set a chain of events into motion, not perhaps realising where it would go, but kind of wanting it to go there.
Oh, I need a bit of fresh air.
It was cruel. I mean, well, Jade had been lulled into a kind of security, if you like, of you can say what you want and it's OK because you're in this protected zone. You can be who you are. Now, in the privacy of our own home, I think every single one of us may well have come up with something that you really wouldn't want to go out into the real world to show, maybe a little hint of the monster inside you, the bigot inside you. They'd made Jade very much feel she was in the privacy of her own home. She's with her mum, she's with her boyfriend, she's in the Big Brother house, it's her second home, it's her first home. It's a real home, it's probably the first real home she's had, you know. And so she can say what she wants, and it comes out like unbelievable poison.
My clients find me as a hugging the, oh, yeah. Because Shilpa, whoever you are, I don't know if I can say her name, Shilpa Bakarada, is just the most important person I've ever seen in my life.
I don't agree with what she said to you. That's fucking bang out of order, because I'm Cameron as well.
Kate Moss invited me back to her house for a party. That's my claim to fame. Not Shilpa Darupa.
Is that what her name is?
I don't know what her name is, but particularly Shilpa Papadum or something.
Did she call her Shilpa Papadum?
Yeah, I mean, that's, like, so stupid and unfortunate.
Jade called her Shilpa Papadom. And it just suddenly became this huge media firestorm. This is a proper crisis. It was completely out of control.
Tonight at 6, Big Brother round goes global.
Is the treatment of Shilpa Shetty for xenophobic and racist?
I think she should fuck off, though.
This is racism being presented as entertainment, and I think it's disgusting.
40,000 people have complained about the programme.
A lot of response from people this morning. Emails, texts, video messages. Here's Leanne from Paisley in Scotland.
Hi there, Jade Goody is an absolute disgrace to Britain.
It's disgusting, to be honest.
I think she's a racist.
You're going to tell me that somebody like that is a role model?
Shilpa Shetty, she's a beautiful lady, and they are slags, and it hurts to watch.
As a viewing public, we have over-promoted Jade Goody, but she's not fit to take any place in a civilised society.
Long before anyone else, he realised that Jade Goody was a racist, pig-faced waste of blood and organs.
It was absolutely insane. The story just got so big so quickly. I remember seeing guys burning effigies of Jade in India. And I thought, this shit has got absolutely out of hand.
It's got a surreal feel, frankly, for the Chancellor and those of us travelling with him halfway around the world.
Gordon Brown's in India to talk about the economy, not reality TV, but even he couldn't escape.
The moment I really remember, there were 27, I counted, 27 Indian TV news crews. And they were only interested in one thing, they were interested in Shilpa Shetty. So Gordon Brown, suddenly he finds himself in a test about a Channel 4 programme he's never watched, a woman he doesn't know, and a Bollywood actress he's never heard of.
We are a nation of fairness and tolerance, and that is how I think most of the world want to understand us.
I just think, how has this happened? We are absolutely off the mat now.
Is this what today's UK is?
This latest row has attracted an extra 1 million viewers in just one night.
Complaints about racism on Celebrity Big Brother are now being investigated by Hertfordshire Police.
Look.
It's extraordinary, isn't it? Because all of this is happening and they haven't got a clue that the world is responding like this.
Oh my God, they are shooting us.
They like it.
Channel 4's chief executive, Andy Duncan, is with me now. Why is nobody, and you, the man in charge, paying the price for this?
The culture of Channel 4 is so intrinsically liberal on something like race that the idea that Channel 4 could be accused of racism by broadcasting this stuff just wouldn't have occurred to anybody. And they were totally ill-equipped for it. They didn't know how to respond.
We have been monitoring extremely carefully events in the House and have reached the view that we cannot with certainty say that the comments directed at Shilpa have been racially motivated or whether they stem from broader cultural and social differences.
She thinks she's above me. And I don't think anybody should be thinking they're above me or below me, for a matter of fact.
I never really bought the argument that this was really about class. I thought it was about racism. And I thought what it exposed was what goes on in Britain. The jokes that people tell, the accents that they put on. And it's not that necessarily this was sort of evil, malicious, aggressive racism, but it was racism.
Broadcasters need to take great care before they publish any such prejudices to millions of people throughout the country.
I have not seen the particular programme in question, therefore can't comment on it, but of course we should oppose racism in all its forms.
The race episode was a massive dose of truth. Jade is suddenly revealing the thoughts of much of the nation that had been largely suppressed in a politically correct couple of decades. The idea that it was a divided nation and it was divided by class.
Crowd here chanting, Tony, Tony.
All of that had been tidied away, especially in the New Labour world, you know, and Britpop and this peculiar optimism that was rooted in nothing other than the Spice Girls. The Liberal world thought it had all gone away, but clearly hadn't, because suddenly this spiked through.
Big Brother heard you refer to Shilpa as Shilpa Fuckawala.
What?
Shilpa Darupa and Shilpa Popadoom.
Yeah, because I couldn't think of her surname. And I was like, I don't know who she is. Why would my family can be talking to someone like that? I don't even know what her surname is. What is it? Shilpa Quakamada, Shilpa whatever, Wakamada, and Shilpa Popadoom. It was just like that, literally like that, just come out like that.
So do we really have a race problem still in this country? Or are we just watching the ramblings of an ignorant and unrepresentative underclass?
Well, we was just like a normal working class family, I suppose. But there's a working class up there, there's a working class here, and there's a working class down here. And we're a working class down here. Jade's always said, right, don't matter where we've come from, fuck the public, we are what we are, and you don't like us, tough.
Twelve years since the closure of the Surrey docks, if Bermondsey ever felt politically ignored, it's getting its share of the limelight now.
Bermondsey was a very National Front area. It had a problem of violence against anyone who wasn't white. And obviously Jade was mixed race. Oh God, we had National Front painted all over our house outside, all on the walls. I had Durexes put through my letterboxes. And what's changed now is you can get done for races if you say brown, packy, whatever. We're not allowed to use them words. I understand that. It's just, you might speak a bit posher because you have an IQ, and we don't.
I want you to know, Shilpa, I am not racist. And when I said that the other day, it wasn't said in any form of racist. But when Big Brother read it back to me, I thought, I cannot have her hear that and think that I am racist because I...
You've said that that's going to be out, and a lot of Indians have heard it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Trust me, it's not going to go down well.
Do you know what? It probably won't go down well, but as long as I've told you, the person that I said it about, you.
But you know, Jade, that sometimes you say things that you can't take back.
Big Brother house, this is
Davina.
Tadhari.
Live on Channel 4. And I can now reveal that the third person to be evicted from the Big Brother house is Jade.
All right.
And I remember thinking, oh my God, what's happened?
You have been evicted. Please leave.
How it can all turn in a nanosecond.
Please leave the Big
Brother. She's now become the most hated girl in Britain.
You have been evicted. Please leave the Big Brother house.
It was a bit like knowing that you're going to ruin someone's life forever. But they don't know it yet. Oof.
Hello.
That's such a weird way to
the
come
weirdest
out,
thing in the
it?
World.
Isn't it so weird. Yeah. Okay. What are you doing? Are you alright?
Yeah.
Come down with me. All will become clear. I don't know how much you know about why these nobody's here or anything like that, but all will come clear after the break. I've got to get you into the studio where we're going to do the interview. Well, what a week.
Jade. All right, you denied being a racist, categorically. But having watched the footage back, can you understand why so many people are just so adamant that you are?
Yes, I can. Okay. I've said I'm sorry to Shilpa, and she's accepted that. And I know sorry won't change people's opinions or people's minds, but I'm not saying it for that. I'm saying it directly to Shilpa's parents. I'm sorry for putting her through what I did. I won't defend myself.
Okay, Jade, thank you very much. The incendiary nature of the whole thing made us really quite worried about it. At the same time, it would have been remiss of me in my job not to hold her to account. Yeah, it's difficult.
Have you thought seriously about maybe I'll just retire from public life and...
I haven't thought about none of it. I haven't thought about what I'm going to do, what I'm not going to do. I just want to get it clear to everybody out there that I'm not a racist and I will turn it around. That's improving myself because the person that I was, I didn't like.
The biggest professional gaffe since Gerald Ratner called his own brand of jewellery. Well, you know what he called it. She has a multi-million pound business empire, which instead of having shareholders, has fans.
The perfume shop has pulled her perfume from its stores.
Ironically, the very programme that created her has killed her.
I went to see her the next day. Oh, God, it's horrible. She was sobbing hysterically, uncontrollably, inconsolable. And I was quite nervous about going to see her, actually, because I thought she quite rightly will hold me responsible for destroying her life, I guess. She sort of didn't really want to speak to me. And I sort of remember walking away and just thinking, God, how's she going to turn this around? And we didn't speak much after that, to be honest.
I saw her immediately after her eviction interview. I hugged her, tried to, you know, calm her down. But I honestly wasn't sure what to do at that stage. I'd never seen someone in such hysterics, and she felt like her life had been ruined, and that was quite hard to take. I felt terrible. Huge amounts of guilt.
Bollywood superstar Shilpa Shetty has won the Celebrity Big Brother.
I was working at the News of the World at the time, and on the paper, people reacted to the growing scandal with glee. For a celebrity-orientated editor like my boss, Andy Coulson, it was manna from heaven. You know, this is an opportunity to shift units. And, yeah, the system turned on her.
And I'm not... I will not justify myself, I will not justify my actions, because they are wrong. They are wrong, and I know they're wrong.
Performance was wrong, and I do sincerely just want to apologise to anybody. I am so sorry. I am. And whether you're white, black, Indian or anything else, I am so sorry, and I am so, so sorry.
the direct objective of the interview was to push her to the point that she broke down into tears. There was no consideration given whatsoever for her personal well-being. There were sort of laughs in the office because, and through some mistake of research, had been put to her something that she had said in the Big Brother house, which she hadn't even said at all, and yet she agreed that she had said it and she apologised for it.
I will not justify myself, I will not justify my actions, because they are wrong. They are wrong. And I know they're wrong.
Over the top. Too much. Look what they done to us, for God's sake. They put my daughter in priory.
Tough world, isn't it, when your claim to fame is very sort of ethereal like hers was. I think she is a victim, but on the other hand, if you put yourself in the front line, then you are there to be shot at.
She was like a mental child.
She was just lying there, just didn't say a word, didn't even say hello, just staring into blankness. It was just horrible to see, and I'd never seen her like that before.
Oh, God, she didn't look like Jay. She wasn't Jay. She sat on doing this, just rocking in this little room she had on the end of her bed, rocking like a mad woman. She didn't know any of us, and all she done was cry and rock. Cry and rock. She wanted out. Not out of the priory, out of life.
There's support information online at channel4.com/support. The series Jade concludes next week at the same time. Coming up, Marcella's off the booze and off the grid. Double game face to end the series. Good times, while we care.